see you, Anantnag. Other dignitaries, dear faculty and students, a very warm good morning and assalamu alaikum to all of you. It gives me immense pleasure to extend a sense of gratitude and a warm welcome to all the dignified guests on my behalf, on the behalf of the management and the faculty, to all the dignified guests to our institution on this special occasion. I'm once again thankful for all the guests who have spared off their valuable time to be with us here today. We have assembled here in connection with the celebration of Science Festival, which we have organized in collaboration with NCSC. And the main objective behind conducting this mega event of Science Fair is to promote scientific temper among our students and to develop in them a sense of curiosity to explore the world. In my opinion, I think the main aim of education should not be just to teach us to how to learn and what to learn, but also to improve our mind in such a way that we should be able to know for ourselves, not to load our memories with the thoughts of others. That is the basic essence of today's program. In fact, NEP 2020 also emphasizes on the conceptual understanding of things, on the critical, analytical, and creative thinking, and the practical application of knowledge instead of rote learning and theoretical knowledge. I proudly announce here that we in DPS ANANTNAG believe that knowledge can be sought beyond the traditional mode, beyond the four walls of the classroom, to give opportunity to the students to explore learning outside the classrooms as well. That's why we from time to time engage our students in outdoor activities, in extracurricular and curricular activities, so that they can explore their potential in the areas of their interest. We aim an overall development of the personalities of our children so that they can be of use, they can be useful citizens, responsible citizens of future. And I think in this era of information technology, artificial intelligence, advanced technology, we need to produce more scientists and innovators than actors and singers. Whenever we think about the inventions and the discoveries of the world, the image of the Western scientists always comes to our mind, because from a small needle to a big airplane, whatever we see around ourselves seems to be the invention, the discovery of the European scientists. Why? Why is this so? Are they superior class in any way? Have they descended from some other world to this planet? Do they have more, are they more intelligent than us? I think not. They are as human as we, Asian people. We have also been blessed by Allah with the same mind, with the same inquisitive mind, with the same brain as they. Then why are we lagging behind? What is the reason? I think the reason is that we lack the opportunity. We lack the required platform for exploring our mind. That is the main reason. However, when I look at the medieval times, which was regarded by the Europeans as the dark age, as the age of blind faith and superstition, we see number of men and women, not from the West, from the East, especially from the Muslim countries, who have pioneered in the field of science, astronomy and math. How could they? They traveled a lot, explored the truths, the world beyond their limits, beyond the horizons set so far. When they could do it with limited resources, why can't we? We have ample resources around us. We have the aid of technology with us. Why can't we do it? Why we always depend on the Westerners to come up with some new invention, new theory, new app? The question is that we have forgotten with the mission with which God has sent us to this world, and that is a mission that He has also reiterated in the Holy Quran, that we have to explore the truths and the world. So the time is that we have to revive that culture of ours. Alhamdulillah, the NCSC, the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, has come up with much needed platforms, opportunities for the young minds of our schools to apply scientific mind to understand situations, issues around them, to try to find out some solution to some problems, and then to discover their solutions. I am highly thankful for the dedicated team of NCSC, Mr. Zahu Sahab, Mr. Shabir Sahab, Mr. Saqib Sahab, with whom I have a 3 months or 4 months association. But I have seen them how they are tirelessly working hard, approaching school by school, district by district, with the proposal, with the platforms that they want to give to those institutions, to the students of those institutions, so that they can explore, so that they can strive for innovative enterprise, improvisation of the already established solutions, or they can come up with some innovative method to deal with these situations. I think innovation is a thing that has always helped us to find solutions to so many problems of the society, from environment to technology to job market and everything in between. There are numberless things that if I want to mention, it would take my whole day. And science, as we have seen, has always been built on innovations, because it is all about discovery. Do you not know that if we have not changed our concept of discoveries and inventions made so far in biology, in physics, in information technology, in digital technology, we would not have been able to discover new things. And the world has not have been advanced to the stage where it is now. where we see what happens, what can happen or is happening with artificial intelligence. So, without taking much time, this is my personal request, wish, suggestion, appeal to all the students out there to switch their interests towards the field of science and research. I also appeal to parents to encourage their kids to ask questions. If we encourage them to ask questions, then this can lead them to the goal of inventions and discoveries or innovations. Because science and innovation is something which can be of use to society in a number of ways. We have seen how it has improved the quality of life on Earth. We have seen how science and innovations have revolutionized everything from communication to transportation, everything that is around us. So once again, I hope that we will have a very hopeful, interactive sessions today. And let me also add one thing, that since this program is conducted by NCSC, there are more than 53 projects, science model projects that have to be displayed and evaluated in the halls inside the building. I also added something more to it. I added some colorful programs that are somehow related to the theme, besides having a competition inviting some schools from the adjoining area for social science model competition, for science model competition, and for poster making competition. With this purpose that students from government schools and other adjoining schools will come and see what others display or also display their own things, they will all get inspiration from each other. So I think the judges or the audience who are here will appreciate the small but very hard task of our students who have tried their level best to produce something which is innovative, which is something new, which is their original, without the support or the help of others. Thank you, sir.